Hey there, what's the idling temperature of my GPU? What's the maximum temperature of the GPU during gaming? How can I reduce the GPU temps? Is that all you have got? Stay tuned because you're going to get answers for these questions. If this is the first time that you are coming across in my channel, or in case if you can't remember my name, this is JK here and you are watching K-Shown Edits. If you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon in order to get notified whenever I upload a new video. Cool? Yeah. Normally, for GTX 10 series cards, the idling temperature will be around 35 to 40 degrees Celsius, and during gaming, it can go up to 80 to 85 degrees Celsius. But the video card manufacturers always claim that their GPU can run up to 93 degrees Celsius. We are going to see the top 6 fixes for preventing the GPU from going nuts. Let's begin. Step number 1. Open NVIDIA control panel in your desktop and go to 3D application settings. In the power management mode, there will be 3 modes, namely adaptive, optimal and prefer maximum performance mode. Turning it to optimal is a shitty thing because it is not going to give you the required power you want, and it also reduces the FPS to a greater extent. On the other hand, keeping it to prefer maximum performance mode will make your GPU go balls to the walls even during loading screen of your game itself, and during the peak times it goes up to 85 degrees Celsius and stays there as constant. Also, when you are watching some movies and browsing, your GPU does work as video output device but idles at a temperature of around 50 to 53 degrees Celsius. Turning the mode to adaptive makes the GPU to adapt according to the workload you are giving. When you do any task other than gaming, the GPU will only work as a display output device and it will always idle around 35 degrees to 40 degrees Celsius. And during gaming, it will go up to a maximum of 75 degrees Celsius. And step number 2. Go ahead and download the MSI Afterburner from the link given in the description box below. Install it with Riva Statistics Tuner checked. Go to the fan monitoring tab and just set your own manual curve as shown in the screen. This manual curve sets your GPU and cools it rigorously when it goes up to 70 degrees Celsius. Now you can say that your GPU will not get fried after doing these two steps. Step number 3. Disclaimer: this step will void your warranty as some video card manufacturers does not want the customers to even open up the GPU while others won't bother it. Just remove the GPU and remove its backplate, unplug the fan and get a thermal paste from a decent brand. Wipe the leftovers of the previously applied thermal paste with the isopropyl alcohol. Rice grain or line method is good for you to go. If you can, just replace the thermal paste once in every 3 to 6 months. Doing so will drastically improve the performance of your GPU gaming. And step number 4, when you are going to buy a new case, just make sure to buy a case that's having a top mounting bracket for fixing up case fans. If you already have one, fix that fan in a position to suck air from outside to within that of the case, because when air is sucked in from the top part of the case, it directly strikes down against the backplate or the soldered PCB board of the GPU. This will definitely improve the GPU cooling to a certain extent. Step number 5. Just buy an adjustable case fan which looks like this. It can be tilted to any side and placed on any sides of the components. In particular, place it above the GPU. A big thumbs up for cooling. And step number 6. This is somewhat rare. Remove the shroud fans which comes in stock with the video card. Install the 80mm case fans with cable ties around the heat sinks. Power off the installed 80mm fans with Molex or motherboard pins. This can also result in cooling, but the only drawback is actually you can't have any control over fan speed. Your fans will begin to spin at the time of booting the computer and it will run endlessly. It will not adapt according to the environment. These are the 6 possible methods
by which you can fix your GPU temperatures. Let me know in the comments below whether this video is useful or not, and leaving a like below and subscribing to my YouTube channel always motivates me to make much more content for this channel. So I hope you enjoyed it. See you soon in the next one. Until then, it's bye from JK signing off.